We turn now to the push for police reform. Just yesterday, the House passed the George Floyd Justice in Policing Act, a sweeping bill that would ban chokeholds, restrict police use of deadly force, and make it easier to criminally prosecute police officers. Senate Republicans came up with their own more narrow bill that was blocked by Democrats. Neither bill is expected to pass, and there's no effort toward a bipartisan compromise. We'd now like to bring in activist Gwen Carr. She is, of course, the mother of Eric Garner, who died in 2014 after a New York police officer held him in a chokehold as he repeatedly said he could not breathe. Thank you so much for joining us, Ms. Carr.
Thank you for having me.
In your support for this House bill, you co-wrote a letter saying that police need to be a, quote, guardian mentality, not a warrior mentality. What would that look like to you, and how could it have saved your son's life?
Well, if the chokehold bill would have been in place, or even if they would have followed policy, I believe my son would have been alive today. Because anything that restricts breathing, and any way, it should not be used. So now that we do have the Eric Garner chokehold bill in effect, we need it to be federal, not just statewide. So it would look like it would save a lot of lives if the police would adhere to this chokehold bill.
And Congress is, of course, now in a stalemate. How concerned are you that despite popular support, they won't be able to pass any police reform law? And are there compromises that the Democrats should make?
No, well, you know, there should not be chokeholds. Because soon as you start making compromises, it's like loopholes. And no police officer should use the chokehold. Although I know they're trying to say, well, if we fear for our life, but that is always the compromise that they want to use, fear for my life. No, it would have to be proven that your life was at stake. Because most time when you see these chokeholds, their life is not at stake. They're doing it because they can and they get away with it.
And do you feel that there are any red lines? In other words, which reforms absolutely should not be compromised away?
Well, really, we don't need any watered down bills like the Republicans are trying to give us all watered down bills. None of them should pass. We need complete, when we get a bill, it should be complete. It shouldn't be, oh, because if this, we'll give you this, but we're not going to give you that.
Your son's death 6 years ago, of course, galvanized the Black Lives Matter movement. Where do you want this movement to go from here?
Well, we have, okay, it's nice that we are demonstrating, we are walking the streets, and we are demanding change. But in order to get this change, we have to go from demonstration to legislation. Mm-hmm. Because yelling in the street, this is not going to get us change. But it brings about awareness that we have a problem. So it's just a problem we need to solve. And now I'm so glad that everyone is in the street to make awareness about the problems that's been going on for centuries. And nothing has really been done about it.
And yeah, you talk about how this has been going on for centuries. Are you surprised that 6 years after your son's death was caught on videotape that we're still seeing the same kind of fatal violence by police against Black people in particular, especially when they're aware of the scrutiny and in many cases that their actions are being videotaped?
Yes, because even when we get it on videotape, we see it's not a slam dunk. Because the police officers, they have this a bill of rights for the police officers, and it seems to go away or get swept under the rug. I had to fight for 5 years, 5 years to get one officer fired. And there's still other officers who's working on the streets that should not be, because they don't belong on the police force, because look at the harm they did to my son. And that's why we need these bills to be passed, and we don't need to be compromising these bills, because there's always loopholes to slip through.
All these years later, do you feel like you've gotten justice?
No, I have gotten a little justice with the one police officer fired, but we need all the police officers fired. It's a step in the right direction, but we have to keep on fighting because there's a lot of work to be done.
Ms. Carr, thank you so much for joining us tonight. We appreciate your time.
And thank you for having me.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.